Hello, and welcome to Let's Play Discworld Part 5. We're going to go to Ankh-Morpork. We have acquired ants, and that is how we're going to get Hex to work.
I'd better get the machine working first.
Okay, so we're going to use our picnic basket full of ants. Some fool let them all run away earlier. Now we have to put them back. Come on, ants. Come out.
Blasted little blighters. Looks like I'll have to entice them out.
How? How do we entice... Oh, no. No, not the honey. Anything but the honey. Ah, I guess we'll have to use it. Look at them. All walking on a trail of honey. Well, we've done it. Now we can use Hex.
I'll best ask Skaz to operate it.
Hi, Skaz. I have an important question for Hex.
So tell me, what wonderful solutions has Hex provided us with of late?
Well, now that you mention it, Hex hasn't done a great deal since I last saw you. It's like, broken. That's not to say that with the right ants, it couldn't like calculate pi or even the Arch-Chancellor's inside leg measurement.
Right, so the ants are in?
Yes, that is correct. Oh, look. They're all running around. They're, you know, keen to get started.
Yeah, anyway, so we are now ready to get going. I mean, I can ask this machine a question now.
Yes, quite right. Ask, you know, ask away.
What do you call this machine again?
Hex. A three-letter name. And it's not because it's, you know, useless. No matter what you might hear people say.
Hex. How lovely. See anything wrong with the name at all?
No. My research assistants seem to think it's very appropriate.
All right, let's just get on with it then, shall we? Right, Hex, I want you to tell me the answer to the question, why? Well?
Ah, well, of course, a certain amount of working time is required for any problem of this type.
Yeah? How long?
According to my estimate, we should have your answer in a jiffy.
A jiffy?
Ah, that is the abbreviation of the Clachian word jiffacitra, meaning eon or age of the world. Probably about 2 million years. Would you like a cup of something while you wait?
Hemlock.
Oh, I don't know if we have any of that in stock. Luke, there's no point in getting uptight. You'll just have to be patient. I mean, it's not as if you can just run off and somehow accelerate time.
Oh yeah? Well, I'm a wizard. A bona fide, pointy-headed, skirt-wearing magic tosser. Although perhaps I should rephrase that. I can do anything I like. I'll accelerate time anywhere I want to, any when, anyhow. I'm going to accelerate time for those little six-legged idiots in there. Let them develop a civilization, new philosophies, and entire galaxies of new perceptions. And then I'm going to jump up and down on the lot of them. Hey, I'm really getting the hang of this science business, aren't I?
Accelerate time? But the only way we could possibly do that is with a pyramid. And we have one right here. Let's try again.
Right, Hex, I want you to tell me the answer to the question, why?
There. Now that wasn't so bad. You see what just a little bit of patience can...
Shut up and tell me the damn answer!
Ah. Now let me see.
Well?
Oh, it says, because.
Is that all? Because?
Well, it also says, blip, 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 out of cheese error. Blip, 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 cannot find drive Z. Blip, 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 unrecoverable application error. Blip, 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 please reboot universe. Blip, blip, blip. Year of the Sloth. Blip, Blip, blip.
Oh, blip.
Fantastic! We've now got our answer. Meaning we can go back to the man in the desert and get our song.
Oh, like, wow. I see, like, a totally new world. It's a view into possibilities that might or might not be. Cosmic uncertainty, man. Kind of like you've got an animal inside this box, only it's a cat.
The box is a cat?
Yeah, but sometimes it's like dead. Oh, man, you just have to climb in this thing for yourself and go for a ride.
See you later.
Mad Drongo, voiced by Neil. I'm going to go off to the man in the desert and get my song. We've got the band, we've got the novelties, we're going to get the song, and next we need to find ourselves a gorgeous babe.
Ooh!
Hello? Hello? Look, am I coming to bedtime?
No, lad, no! We're just settling down to a nice evening by the fire.
I brought the answer, you know, to why.
Well done, lad, well done!
It's probably not what you expected.
Out with it!
It's a bit short.
Speak up, lad, speak up!
Well, all right. It's not really very conclusive. It just says, because. Then it says, blip, 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 out of cheese error. Blip, 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 cannot find drive Z. Blip, 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 unrecoverable application error. Blip, 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 please reboot universe. Blip, 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 you're the sloth. Blip, blip, blip.
Angus! Angus, you were right! You were right! You were right! Angus, stop doing that right now and listen to me!
Normally, I'd hang around long enough to check the goods, but in this case, a frenzied departure might be more advisable.
We've done it! We've got a jingle for our film! Now what? I'm going to go back to Hollywood. I think it's about time we checked on Death, because we've also got some shots of the Elven Queen, meaning the makeup artist will know what to do. She's going to be inspired.
Hello.
I've got what you asked for.
Right, stand back and here we go.
Smoking.
Gosh. Well, that's that. Now, where are we going to find a gorgeous babe for our clicky? Oh, come on, there's got to be one round here somewhere. Maybe we could try this trailer.
Nope, can't budge it.
Oh. Mr. Troll, I can't get through that door.
So you're the security round here, are you?
Security? Ah, that's right. I'll look after the what's-its, the sets, that's it. And the trailers and the canteen.
Canteen? So tell me, what's the food like here?
Oh, I wouldn't know. I order in. Yeah, the local quarry delivers now a good choice of fine rocks at competitive prices. They even supply ketchup, you know.
What? You eat rocks? Must be awful on your teeth.
Nah. Troll teeth are the hardest substance known, and they're always sparkling clean, too.
Like diamonds.
How do I get into that trailer over there?
What? Through the door? You mean you want to go through the door?
Well, of course that's what I mean.
Now what do you want to go doing that for?
Because the wall has a solid, wall-y kind of look. The key, right?
Well, I could only really give the key to someone who could provide me with 3 rooster feathers, a piece of string, and a huge clockwork.
That's it. No, I draw the line right there. No quest, no items, no pathetic excuses for, quote, lateral thinking as I go stumbling about trying to guess what I have to fetch this time. Just give me the key.
Why? I had my heart set on that piece of string.
All right, we'll try logic. Now look. Are you aware that there are multiple outcomes to each and every action that we take? Just say yes.
Yes.
Right. Well, that means that somewhere in the universe, there's an alternative world where you've already given me the key. Say yes.
Yes.
So since you've already given it to me, there's no harm in me taking the thing in hand right now. I mean, I've already used it once.
Oh, right you are then. Here you go.
There. Let's see them make a game puzzle out of that one.
Wow! Who would have thought that would have worked? Hello. Let's go. The milkmaid.
It was a cutout all the time. I could have just walked around. Don't say a word. Just don't say a darn word.
Mm-hmm.
What do you want now, then?
I was just wondering whether you were free. That is, if you might consider being part of a very special clicky that we're making.
Oh, sure. But I get lonely on the set. You'll have to find me a little friend.
Friend?
Yeah, I lost my last one, you see.
Friend! Oh, I see. For your ring. A little friend. Right. No rest for the weary. The Milkmaid. From rags to riches to skimpy lingerie, all in one fabulous lifetime.
Oh, I see. So, by friend, she doesn't mean an imp. She means she wants a diamond. But where are we going to find a diamond? Oh, yes. The troll's teeth. Sparkling clean. Maybe we'll give him some rock. Trolls like eating rocks.
Anyway, here, try some candy rock. I bought it over from Jelly Baby, specially for you.
Oh, thanks.
I do this as part of the game, but let me just say, this actually makes me feel kind of bad.
Oh, my tooth. Oh, no, my tooth. Oh, it hurts. Oh, it hurts me. Oh, I want my mummy. I want my mummy now.
Okay, don't cry. Limescale everywhere. I'll see what I can do to pull it out for you.
No.
Aw. Poor guy. Well, don't worry, because we've got a rope here.
Here, let me try something. This should work.
There. That's better. And we've got a diamond. Well, it's a tooth, but a diamond tooth. One I think the milkmaid will like. What a diva.
One diamond, reasonably clean, all for you. Now get out there and star in my clicky, or I'll take away all your makeup and ban you from ever visiting a hairdresser again.
You heartless beast. Gee, anyone would think you've been round the world for this here thing.
You have no idea. Well, I think we've done it. We've got a gorgeous babe. We've got a jingle. We've got the band. We've got novelties. And we help find the right look for our leading man. So I reckon that's about it. I can see it all now. Death, the movie. He's going to be so popular.
I found the band, Mr. Dibbler.
Excellent. Are they good? Do they have the sleek, well-fed look of success?
Good gods, no. They're all musicians.
Oh, well, sign them on. That's the drawback of music, having to have all these musicians around.
I can't stand musicians. Anyway, here's a jingle.
All right, we've got it. Here it is, one prime jingle, just for you.
I don't know. Can you get me another one?
What?
Only kidding.
That's not funny. Okay, so next, the milkmaid.
I found us our babe, Mr. Dibbler.
Can she act?
Of course she can act. She's a thespian.
Yeah, well, that won't matter. That's very trendy these days. Fine. Well, consider her signed up.
Brilliant. It's all coming together. And last but not least, the novelties.
Here we go. Novelties.
Novelties? You call these novelties? I've never seen the likes of this sort of thing before.
Exactly. That's why they're novelties.
I suppose so. I hate it when logic turns against me.
But can you go and get philosophical on someone else's time, please? Some of us have got a game to play. That's it. I think we have everything. The jingle, the band, the girl, the novelties. Not to mention that the lead actor's out of makeup and ready to go.
Right then. So it's lights, camera, Angstrom.
Don't you mean action?
Oh, well, I suppose so, if you think that's easier. Come on, we've got some filming to do.
I'm ready for my close-up now, Mr. Dibbler.
All right! Lights! Camera! Achtung! Actin? Actinium? I'll get on with it! Cue death!
Now is the winter of our discontent, made all the more drizzly by the lack of death. Ooh, to be or not to be, that is the question. Whether to be extremely cool, reach the heights of fashion and snuff it, or to keep drawing breath and lose all fashion sense forevermore.
So, what do you think?
I'm trying not to.
Ready? Cue piano!
Piano?
Roll 'em!
Makeup! Now is the winter of our discontent, made all the more drizzly by the lack of death. Ooh, to be or not to be, that's the question. Whether to be extremely cool, reach the heights of fashion and snuff it, or to keep drawing breath and lose all fashion sense forevermore.
Ready for the porcelain scene?
Look, can we just discuss this script for a moment?
Roll 'em!
Makeup!
Poor death.
Now is the winter of our tent, the discontent, made all the more drizzly by the lack of death. Oh, to be or not to be, that is the answer. Whether to be extremely cold, reaching the heights of fashion and sniffing, or to keep drawing breath and lose all fashion sense forevermore.
Okay, everyone! The being smashed by a safe scene. And roll 'em!
Now look here! Makeup!
Now, Mr. Dibbler, now!
What? What's he talking about?
Nothing, love, nothing. Now look, I've told you before, it'll be far too messy.
Help! I want to see my agent!
All right, now, Death, stand by for Julian's extra special scene. And cue...
Wait a minute! What's all this about a special scene?
Read your script, love. Here, Julian, explain how this next bit goes, will you?
It goes whoosh! Blam! Stuff flying everywhere!
Did you not tell our boy that there were special scenes involved?
I'm not doing it.
Oh, all right. I'll go and find a stunt double. Honestly, you get some people in front of a camera and they think they're the Queen of the May. A skeleton stunt double, indeed.
What? So, we're not done yet. But where are we going to find a skeleton stunt double?
Maybe right here, in Ankh-Morpork.
Hello there!
Ha! A likely story. That's just the sort of attitude I've come to expect from you living fascists.
What? I never said a word.
Words? Yeah, right. That's where it starts. Dead common. Dead boring. You've used them. Don't say you haven't.
I'm not prejudiced. I'm dead set against it.
See? There you go. If there's ever going to be any justice for us undead, then we have to start at the grassroots.
Oh, a bit lower than that, surely.
Don't you try to dictate our level of activity. Livey, dead right. That's what we want. So if you're not dead, then drop dead. This club's for the children of the night, so if you want to live it up, right, you go elsewhere.
Wow. Well, the people in this place appear to be dead, so let's show them that we can be just as dead as they are with our death certificate.
Oh, so you are dead then? I should have guessed from the fashions. All right, in you come, Brother...
Rincewind.
Brother Rincewind, in you pop, the meeting's just starting. Greetings, brothers!
And sisters.
Oh, sorry. And sisters, allow me to introduce our newest member.
Rincewind.
Rincewipe.
Rincewind. Wind.
That's just a touch of gas, brother. Happens to the best of us.
Poltergast?
What?
Is he a poltergast? What? Him being a wind and all?
Yeah, probably. Any road. Brethren and brother women. Let us now all join in singing our Fresh Start Club anthem. A one and a two.
Ankh-Morpork, Ankh-Morpork, Ellen that serves the blood. Its streets, its thousands palaces, its strangely sticky mud. Let not some wicked foreigner thine nobleman's besmirch, and we will fight with tooth and nails when we can stand and lurch.
My friends, we don't have to take death lying down. I see a land where the dead will take their place alongside the living, albeit most of them propped up or sewn back together, but still beside the living. A place where ghosts can throw off their chains and help contribute to a better, more just society. Where a man can throw up his head in pride, then tuck it back under his arm, raise his right hand, if he can remember where he put it, and say, yes, I'm as dead as hell, and I'm not going to take it anymore.
Well, I think we can all agree they're good singers.
Count not far out to a vampire with social pretensions. It's amazing how vampires always have to be wearing evening dress, isn't it? I mean, it's not as if many people are likely to invite them to parties.
And over here?
The Countess not far out to, I presume. I'm glad she's a bride of darkness. I'd hate to see her if the lights were on.
Yeah.
Good old Windle. Still not quite getting the hang of being dead, but I admire a man who can just keep trying.
This person looks familiar.
The world's shyest bogeyman. Oh well, if you're going to have an embodiment of childhood neuroses, at least it can be one that you don't mind inviting over for tea and biscuits from time to time.
And I recognise this person from Discworld 1.
Hello.
You're not frightened of me, are you?
No, why?
Oh, I just don't seem to frighten anybody anymore these days.
Oh well, sorry. All right, look, I'm scared. Really scared. Terrified. Is that making you feel any better?
You're not really scared.
I am.
Well, why aren't you running around then?
Because I'm scared stiff. Yeah, that's it. I've been scared into that strange lucid state of unreality and just don't seem to be able to move my legs. Rooted to the spot in terror. Me.
Really?
Gosh, yes. If I was any more scared, my ears would drop off. Trust me on this.
Poor guy.
See you later.
How about this guy?
Excuse me.
Shush!
Oh.
Reg Shu, a zombie with a mission. I'd shake hands with him, but I might end up with more fingers than I started with. A male banshee? Oh, well, it takes all kinds, I suppose. I wish it didn't, but there you are.
And lastly, a skeleton in the closet.
Oh, hello. What are you doing in there? Apart from being a quest item, I strongly suspect. Well, I can see your point there. Actually, I'd get that scene to you if I were you.
She's perfect.
I was just wondering whether a career in the Clickies might be just exactly what you're looking for.
Oh, I see. The local Actors League won't let you in until you have proof that your family's from overseas. Bloody cheek of some people. I'll tell you what. I'll have a look around and see what I can find to help prove your case for Sheep in the Arts. I'll get some evidence that proves that your ancestors came from distant climes.
I think I have just the thing.
Well, that's it for now.
How about this? This'll do.
A film of Neolithic sheep artwork. Yes, not particularly interesting, but I still feel there's an award in this somewhere. Who might want proof that sheep come from a long way away?
Wow. He practically tells you what to do with this.
Here you are. Some evidence that your ancestors came from the land of Forex. Now you can be a stunt sheep. No, no, don't thank me.
He certainly won't be thanking you after Julian's special scene.
Cue death!
Now is the winter of our discontent, made all the more drizzly by the lack of death. Ooh, to be or not to be, that is the question. Whether to be extremely cool, reach the heights of fashion and snuff it, or to keep drawing breath and lose all fashion sense forevermore.
Fine, everyone! Cut and paint!
Ah, this is more of a lark, watching someone else work for a change.
That was beautiful, baby. Just beautiful.
Wait a minute. Feathers? It was just feathers?
What? Didn't you read the script? It's Julian's special scene.
Ah, showbiz. Fame and fortune, I hear you calling.
Welcome to our audience and welcome to Death, the latest star to rise and shine in the land of Hollywood. Death, how do you feel about your up-and-coming premiere?
I don't feel. I am Death.
What he means is that he's confident that the product will speak for itself. That we've got something really astounding, really new, really, really...
What?
Look, just try to appear less skeletal or something, will you?
Yes, well, perhaps you might explain to us just why you feel death is the sex symbol for today's world.
Well, Trish, we've always known that the height of style is pure, elegant restraint. And, of course, when it comes to wearing black, he's always been the trendsetter.
Fabulous, fantastic. Well, that's it from outside the Odeum here tonight. This is Trish Looks Good inviting one and all to join me here tonight and get reaped. Excuse me, do they have those chocolate-coated ice creams here? The one with the little bits of nuts on them?
They only had insect lava flavour.
Insect lava?
Some new invention imported from 4X, apparently. When's this clicky starting, then?
Yes, hurry up! Some of us have to get back to bed before dawn.
Farewell to all your bills, rip up all your wills, and pop your final bills. Amen.
Rubbish!
I say, this is appalling.
Ugh! I haven't seen anything this awful since I saw the Dean in the showers.
Best way to lose weight, it's a tete-a-tete with fate.
Well, that didn't cut the mustard.
No, 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 I thought it was awful.
Oh no, it's all going wrong. Right, we need to do something. Let's take down the reel. we're going to do some last-minute editing.
Well, this looks like it fits.
Okay, what should we do? What have I got?
Leftover film of the Elf Queen, eh? Still some good footage here.
Maybe we could splice some in.
Now I think I'm onto something here. What if I splice in a few shots of the Elven Queen? Sort of subliminal, you might say. That should make them sit up and take notice.
Yes! Fiendish. Fiendish, Rincewind. This is going to work. Let's try again. I hope this works. It's the only way to get Death back doing his job.
That's Death. Say farewell to all your bills. Rip up all your wills. And pop your final pills. Amen. That's Death.
Oh, my. I do say how marvellous.
Oh, beautiful. Simply beautiful.
I wish my smell could have seen that.
Oh, that was better than being alive ever was.
Now, that's what I call real charisma. He'll go far, he will, a real star.
Oh, shut up. It seemed like a good idea at the time. How was I to know the Spectre of Death was going to become a pop icon? Now he says he doesn't want his old day job back. Now he's a style setter. Now millions of girls are cramming themselves into undersized, tight, black lace costumes with lots of black lace, all dyeing their hair black, wearing black lace and black nail polish and deep plum lipstick and black lace and being pale and very, very interesting. God, I hate wearing this dress. What do you mean it's all my fault? Well, no, I don't think that's a good idea at all. No, it's just not my cup of tea.
You mean I have to become Death?
Hmm. Well, I suppose it'll help me make new friends.
Rincewind, the new Death. How's that gonna work?